one frame. Take this. Okay, this time, without the crit, please. Okay. Out of the lab. We did it. Now we'll die to a level 4 Rattata or something. I need 47 XP total from wild Pokemon. So another level 3 Pidgey will not cut it, but a level 3 Rat, I think, does. Turn frame. center my defenses. So I guess I'm gonna have to catch something a little later. That's still not enough XP, so I'm gonna have to just ember a bug or something. So rash nature. So 18 from minus 1 rock tomb. See if I happen to get an encounter here. Switch the moves. I could have tried to do minion strats, but I think the goal of the day is safety whenever possible. Ignore the items. Very low number of encounters. I just have to do minion if I don't see anything. Well, it's kind of late for that now. Alright, so we'll just defeat that for XP. So HM Slave's gonna have to come from Route 3 or Route 4 later on, so that'll be some time loss. With the fake time save coming up on this split. Okay, 7. That's just one down input, that's right. Okay, I don't have to go all the way around. So we'll potion before killing Geodude. Risk 17, maybe? I gotta risk that now. Didn't remember about the speed factor. He always rock tombs if you're a certain speed. Okay. So I'm not sure what the minus 2 range is. I'm gonna assume like 15. Ooh, man, these crits. Okay, I kinda wanna risk this now. Wow, what a weird fight. That still would have been massive time save regardless, but we are going to lose some of that back because I still need a slave. So we will see how that goes. Okay, I'm kind of near Blaze right now. Which is good, potentially. Just got to be a little careful. Thank you. Also, I gotta keep track of my embers. I know we were able to save one on Geodude. 12, okay. Lass's Rattata does 9 with Quick Attack. Rocket's Rat does 10. So I want to see Quick Attack turn one here. Okay, burn. Why is this HP not listed? Okay, what am I at? 14, okay, 3 more. Let's see if that works. I need to fix that later. It's either 10 or 11 HP. Eight embers. Of course, this health is going to get ruined probably by the slave that I need to catch if I see one on Route 3. Grab bird. We're winning so far. The winning can continue. I need this. Okay, I actually need to heal this. That kind of sucks. Berry. Yeah, I was not willing to risk quick attack range there. Should be above Hyper Fang range. See, ideally the repel would wear off right in front of the rocket, so I could just use another repel with the Bagman Imp. Supersonic means I keep the berry. Thanks for the good luck, Genja. Alright, so not low HP for this fight. I think I can double Ember Grimer. I think I have enough, yeah. Just don't disable me. Decent fights. Okay, so we got the bird HM slave, so we will catch, or we will teach Cut to Charmeleon later. Correct movement, but whatever. Okay, goodbye, Metal Claw. And Mega Miss. Center. Worst fight in the run coming up, which was horrible in PB. So we are going to take the safety shop again, and safety save, so nothing has to get messed up. Candy. what are we looking at for damage here? Pretty typical, 20 and 30 from Water Gun. 10 from Quick Attack. 12 from Pidgeotto's Quick Attack. See whether he's gonna switch or not. That's right. I can maybe fix that. And he went into the rat. Okay, this is a weird fight now. Yeah, this is a fight you don't see very often. I might just want to restart. Also have never seen him withdraw this many times. Any crit, I would have lived that. Yep, this is such a bad fight, especially since I'm not quite used to all the weird nuances of it yet. So because he was burned, he wasn't able to kill my level 6 Pidgey, which was only a level 6 because I couldn't catch a slave on Route 1. Yep, very bizarre. Quick attack. Okay. Now just hit the first kick at least. You can do it. Just get him before he boosts his defense. Thank you. Is this the one where you do 30% with Blaze Ember? I think I have to kick. Okay, at least we hit it. Okay, and then we can Ember that. We're not dead to Rattata's Quick Attack. Oh great, we missed the range, whatever. I should have scratched that second hit. Wasting PP. Whew, alright. Got him! And we're in Blaze. Yeah, that was pretty much the worst split of my first run, so that's why we still saved a massive amount of time. Alright, hopefully I didn't blow through too many embers. That was kinda sketchy. Don't have any quick attack calcs for these bridge trainers. I don't think we're dead to any of them. Like, there's a Pidgey in the next fight. If I live the quick attack from Pidgey, I think I can potion. Eh, not quite. I think I'll save in front of Wayne. Because I am going to risk the rock throw from Onyx. So we can stay in Blaze. Getting tired? This is actually time save. I think my first run didn't really have a lot of Blaze here. So a lot of these two-hit KOs are now one-hit KOs. Like that Mankey. Gonna actually use the elixir coming up with the save. We do not want to see that. We are for sure dead if he hits it. Definitely don't take 12 from the next quick attack. Alright. Skillful trainer dodge. Remember to use the TM buffer this time. Okay, so Embers basically just have to last through the boat. Like, until we get to the boat. Ideally, they would last through the rival fight on the boat, but I can take the heal when we first get there if I need to. No quick attack. Blaze Ember for that. Almost time to start hitting more Mega Kicks. I might just heal for safety on the Raticate fight. Also, I kinda wanna get that. Just to have. Could be useful for buffering Blaze HP later on. Alright, so we definitely have enough embers to at least make it to the boat. Might even have enough to just two-shot Raticate with embers, so I don't even have to hit the Mega Kick. Bill. I think that's roughly where you split. Yeah, saved a pretty decent amount of time there. All right, Char, I need you to hit. I think we died of confusion. Might die to headbutt. And that wouldn't have been a terrible death anyway, because we just get sent to the Cerulean Center. Forget the rare candy, and then super potion. It's just gotta be its own menu, I think. We're about to buy more of those. No. Okay, first big mistake of the run here. That's a lot of XP. Could have candied before this fight, but I think we'll play as if I didn't hit that trainer. Alright, it's just double ember. Thanks, No2H. It's like 5 text boxes after he gives you the item. Seven supers. Candy now. Okay, nice. I just learned you can hold down the A button to skip the cutscene. Double Ember, because I'm not really too keen on trying the Death Warp strats today. Still gotta kind of map out the fight while being poisoned, because it's not super explicit in the notes. I'm supposed to... Supposed to press select there to open that up quicker. This is over scratch, right? Yeah. Alright, that HP should be fine. Dude. Okay, not a great place to menu. Sand, please. Torrent does 36. Wasn't likely to kill from there. Alright. Brick break that. Mega punch Kadabra. HP is nowhere near low enough to be worth trying to death warp on a trainer here. I actually did find a trainer in one of the rooms nearby that is pretty reliable damage. Not sure if it's faster. But definitely not with this HP. So we just run back. I guess now that I've already hit that trainer, I don't have to go through the grass there, but probably should, just to practice the movement. Okay, then save before Misty. 25 attack, okay. Probably gonna be kick plus punch. I didn't heal, did I? How much damage do you do? Okay, that's too much. Wasn't sure if Staryu always went for the water pulse right away, or if it just did something else. Alright, that's my bad. Last run, I actually took the ship heal before it came straight here, so I didn't have to think to menu. Had no calcs for Staryu. Hit the kick. Yeah, I'm not in blaze though, I can't really risk that. Alright. Easy first try. Grab our bike. Then we enter Rock Tunnel of Hell. And also teach Cut. down. It was an optional I hit on this route in my first run. That probably wasn't quite fast enough to guarantee the pass, but it worked out. I guess this upcoming hiker just never looks up, because I see everybody YOLO him, so I guess he's pretty safe. My bugs. Take the super again. Okay. Repel. Hit mega kicks. It's easy. Just hit the kicks. Also, no bone club would be nice. Alright, well now I gotta keep track of water gun damage. Max, okay. Alright. Just a couple more kicks to hit. Easy every time. Let's go. Alright, gonna heal with the repel. Kinda tempted to go get that revive. But if I save in all the right spots, we should be okay. Thank you. Alright, be nice. As we brick break spam for a little while. Don't crit. Okay. Okay, well now this should wear off, at least before the next dangerous hiker, so I can combine menus again. This Graveler's 32. I think I wouldn't necessarily heal if I was being risky. Breaking of bricks. Bitch. Hold the button down. I had it. Alright, so since I couldn't heal to full without wasting another item, we're dead if he gets a mag 9 or 10. But he's not guaranteed to use the move, either. He's not even favored to use the move, it's just random AI, pretty much. Be nice! That shouldn't kill. That is pretty solid HP, actually. I like that. Okay, so don't hit this trainer. Oh my god. I was on the wrong tile. I think that's a reset, actually. Yeah, this is the guy with 3 Cubones. Fuck! That was such good health that I had to. For some reason, I thought I was on the tile next to him. Well, that was a fatal mistake. Thank you. Also, why am I out of brick breaks here? I used extras somewhere. I should have two after this fight. Oh, well, that's RIP. Okay, cool. Alright, can this run stop sucking? I was kind of hoping to get a decent time today. It's all falling apart. I don't know where I use those extra brick breaks. That's interesting. Oh, because I didn't heal on the boat on my way out. That's right. I guess we'll just take Lavender Center. Interesting. Okay, well, we now have one to spare. I think I'm still gonna take the center. okay. Let's play it extra cool there. Yeah, I can't even be sure of my Ember PP situation. I think I used a couple on the rival fight. Yeah, I should have just taken the center before entering Rock Tunnel. So that's why I was mysteriously missing PP. I mean, I should have healed on the boat after the rival. Which is what I meant to do. Yikes. Okay. So this is a center I should not normally have to take. Getting used to the pace of this speedrun. Much faster paced than all the cutscene heavy games I'm used to. They give you plenty of time to think. It's been a while since I've done one like this. Ever since, like, Emerald, probably. Torchic runs. Quite a while ago. To practice that optional dodge in Rock Tunnel. It's like the scariest one in the game, too. It's in the dark, so you can't just, like... You gotta build muscle memory if you want to do it fast. rare candy after this fight. I hope I didn't skip a candy accidentally. So I should have only one right now, I think. And I had such good HP after that first time I defeated the hiker, and I had to hit the optional. That was an irredeemable time loss, though. Three slow pokes, no mega kicks. Yeah, I just had to retry. Losing time here because I took the center. All right, get fly, go shopping. Definitely pressed A before you moved. Hey, Splendids, thanks for the good luck. Speed. I only need one. Nice. Yeah, let's get an extra one of these, too. That's right, we do have good speed. That'll save a little time later. PC Pokemon were nice. Okay, don't have to save PP since we took the center. kind of still want to cut the Zubat anyway, since it saves an input. And text. Easy. Push it again. Tried to do the right arrow, didn't let me. So super high HP for Giovanni. Mega Punch is gonna do up to 40. No, that's the wrong fight. 33. Shouldn't really have to worry about that here unless Onyx crits Rock Throw or something. Yeah. We can Ember away here, we got plenty. Team 16. Escape rope out. To that gym we skipped. That NPC is really in the worst spot. Alright, cans were pretty terrible in my last run, so got some time to save here for sure. Teach fly with one of these pauses before I forget. Beautiful. First try. Every time. The best luck I have had today. Hey, what's up, Kid Rocker? Thank you for the good luck. So we at least don't get to see the massive time loss that most top runners suffer in this gym. At least for today. Yeah, it's a little bit of time save. A smidge. And one tile before lining up. Okay, very high HP once again. Nice that we get at least one sort of push over rival fight in this run. A lot of useless crits there. Wow. Flamethrower puppers. I think my first run started to forget the rare candy pickup and missed the Marowak range. It's a little bit of time save here. Pretty easy split though, as long as I don't do that. Alright, so we'll lose a little bit, but that's fine. I actually wasn't sure. Completely sure that that was wrong to do, so now I know. Like, I wasn't sure if I was just being too safe in my first run by taking that one extra step down. Because I never paid enough attention to the movement in other people's runs. So, yeah. Okay, I need to practice this place again, because I only practiced it, like, once before my first run. I'd, like, completely forgotten. Alright, so Repel will wear off early. So we'll lose, like, no more than 30 seconds, hopefully. Maybe less if I get the Marowak range. Sub 235, still alive. More huge time saves at the Elite Four as well. Lining up with something on the left to get the rare candy. This left side, yeah. Be gone. Missed two runs in a row. think this drowsy was the range coming up. Rival doing to me? 54 with water gun. It's not an official other category. I just prefer Charmander route over Squirtle. If it were its own category, though, yeah, I guess it would be an all main. There is one for round two as well, yeah. Still haven't decided yet if I'm gonna learn round two. Okay, I need to split. Buying 836. Fifth floor, dodge the spinner a few times. I think my first run took the elevator. I'm not supposed to do that. Second, I'll get to that. Okay. Guess we're still saving for this fight. Shell Ticey. Thank you for the raid. Nice crit, dude. use this and then Super Potion, I think. Okay. It's out of Water Gun range. Both died to Boat Rival. Dang, sorry to hear that. I'm still at the point where I'm playing safe as hell. Wow, double protect. Nice. Okay, so Flamethrower PP is a little bit of an issue. Probably can't go for my Sunny Day strat on Viridian Rival now. Because I need a Flamethrower for that. Yeah, and I've never tried Squirtle Route, so I'm not entirely sure how the risk compares. Exactly. It is pretty risky for most of the first half, though. I'm in a potion with the safety save and the rare candies. Yeah, it's definitely a much faster paced game overall than, say, Colosseum. Just a little bit. Almost at the point where we can pick up a revive without losing repel steps. Probably could buy them in Saffron, I'm not sure. I have to check that. Alright, so this Mega Punch can kill. 34 to 40, so it's not likely. And he can miss the move, too. Alright. I do have the Oran Berry. Alright, just don't miss this Nidoqueen range. I missed it in my last run. Not sure if it even is a range still at 30. Okay. Escape Rope, Sabrina. No, they are down, right? damn sign. Alright, top left. Bottom left. Saffron does sell them, alright, yeah. I'll keep that in mind as a safety strat. Because I actually do safe shopping that ends up with spare money anyway, so... Let's see, do I even need to Oranberry? Sludge does 31 in both cases. Okay, I shouldn't have to. Unless I just wanted to make the flamethrower range better, but... kind of hurting on flamethrowers, so I'm probably gonna just Ember flamethrower the muck. Hopefully not get poisoned. Yeah, I did have a pretty nasty death on Sylph Rival in my first run. Oh, we escape right out of here. Whoops. It's one of the few gyms you can do that, I guess. Don't hit the cyclists. A lot of movement in this section. Not too difficult, though. What am I doing? Every optional that I've hit this run has just been sheer stupidity on my part. I don't know why I thought he was turned a different way. I think they all seem to start in their default down position. I think I remember that being a thing in Emerald. So yeah, you always will have to wait for them to turn somehow. Okay, everybody good? Okay, I didn't use any flamethrowers there, at least. Oh yeah, I need this. Keep throwing away all this time save. Yeah, I'm probably just gonna stick with any percent for a while. It's nice having a short speed run. I mean, at least it will be short when I actually get good at this game. This way. Okay, let's pick up this revive. Which, thankfully, is pretty easy to know where it is. Alright, then we just fly. Yeah, I technically started with gold Maniplus as well, back when there was no Manip. Fun times. Good old Cyndaquil route. Goes well for you. Okay, I do need to remember to elixir. Not candying, but I am saving. Okay, thank God. I'll just save here. I think it's likely enough we win. I don't need to be super close to Koga. Okay, so we Ember this. Ember the first hit of We're not dead to sludge, we just really don't want to get poisoned, is the main thing. That burn just saved me. that's annoying, though. Should I just go for acid armor? No, he's definitely going to go for the kill. He has good AI. And we save flamethrowers. So I could go for the good rival strat again, maybe. It's like you ember every other coughing in this run. Okay. How much we taken from a takedown here? Figure that out in a sec. Oh lordy. That fight was about as interesting as my Sabrina fight last time. I think 80 should be fine. Okay, strength boulder, candy. Okay, so Takedown's gonna do 22, Fire Blast is 25. He's probably gonna go Fire Blast like he did in my last run then. I need to learn when cursor memory is a thing and when it's not. Okay, so we just blitz right past this trainer if we stay on this line, right? Oh, I didn't repel. I think I made that mistake in my last run, too. I don't know why it's hard to remember to repel there. This is gonna wear off. But I need to rare candy when it does. Oh, interesting. You can just walk on that tile. Shouldn't need this Carbos. To move away from this guy. That's the second B. Third B. So this Blaine fight was pretty bad in my first run, so hopefully he just keeps hitting me and doesn't just miss every one of his moves and then eventually roar me. Thank you. can ember these, right? I hope that didn't ruin the good rival strat. It probably did, though. Actually, I think we're back to the normal amount of flamethrowers used since I saved one on Koga. Yeah, I think we're good. Should be able to just keep this health. I didn't candy. That's fine if I do it now, right? That should be fine. Yeah, using candies later than you're supposed to is fine for the XP route, usually. I'm pretty sure that's fine. We're gonna lose a little bit. I guess we'll find out. If it somehow isn't fine, I guess I can just kill an encounter in Victory Road or something. Because, yeah, 53 is kind of assumed for the very first Pokemon in the Elite Four. It's kind of important. Guess we'll see. Okay, Ember the Nidorina. Still have to save one on Dugtrio. Mr. Giovanni going from 30 IV pokes to 0 IV pokes. Alright, big rival fight. Two X specials. No crits allowed. Last flamethrower. Praise the sun. He can actually. Wow. Okay. Was I not in kill range from there? Whatever, just waste a turn. Alright. Then we just start blasting. Okay, we easily get 52 here. That's what I worried about. Sunny Water Gun did 36. Okay, so he only did like 70, 72 with no sun. Fire blast that poor bastard. Okay, I think I get the citrus. Use it for Lorelei. A lot of bad things happened on Lorelei in my last run, so this is like my last gigantic time save. So long, Charmander world record. Will we catch up to you eventually? Who knows? Thank you. these bonks. I think that's gonna be the last one. No, one more. Okay. Didn't have the candy yet anyway. Rare candy with the repel. Gotta select it again. Alright. Yes, we are at the Indigo Plateau. Thank you. I'll get used to that menu. Also, I didn't pick up the citrus berry. Guess we're gonna go without it. So unfortunately, we gotta play a little safe here. Surf. Surf. All right. Gotta hit the move. Easy. Gotta hit one more still, though. is one of the riskier branches, unfortunately. I need to put these Pokemon in the right order in the notes. Some of these branches are wrong. Alright, please hit. All of my A press. Easy time save. Alright. How much is Onyx doing? 84 or 60 at plus one. Alright, we heal. He really is very, very unlikely to kill with two rock tombs. That was a close to max roll. I'm not dead to a second one. Special. Might be in Mach Punch range, though. I am not. I'm 1 HP out. Oh, no, 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 no. I'm not plus 1, though. I guess super? Does a potion do enough? Not quite. That's good health, though. I would have had to heal anyway after the fight. 46, yeah. Gengar can only do 37 max. And we don't have to X speed on Agatha. So as long as you don't get Troll Toxic turn one, that's a free fight. Alright, a little bit of an awkward fight. Just XX. Show me double team. Excellent. That's Agatha. Heal and Elixir for Lance. Definitely save for that one. Alright, points. Then we just fire blast everything here. Just enough PP. We could flamethrower the last one if we had to. But we X-Axe, so this move can't miss right now. Doing here? Hyper beam range 99 or 66. Do I need to X speed here? Yeah, I do. Always. This is the one fight you always do it. Plus 5 blaze. I think I still fire blast Dragonite, yeah. X accuracy, so it's safe. Even if I was only plus 4, it's still a favorable range. Should be 100% after an X-Ack, pretty sure. Alright, see how Pidgeot's AI cooperates here. So once again, no X speed here. Got plenty for Alakazam. Guard spec. I do have one extra. Okay. Two. Three. Nice. That was a fast setup. Hit. Alright. And I am not in E-speed range. So we could go for the Fire Blast on Arcanine, just get the fast, fast finish here. Oh wait, no, Flamethrower is guaranteed at plus 4 Blaze, right. Nice. Just gotta not get crit. Alright, doggo, be a friendo. Didn't even go for it. Okay. GG. I thought we split there. Yeah, though, decent improvement, for sure. God, what a fast-paced game. I am really glad I made this little damage spreadsheet for myself, though. A little easier to find the damage ranges that I take from certain moves when it's in a spreadsheet form. Yeah, actually playing that fight correctly and getting a fast setup, too. Didn't have to heal. That is going to be a hard champ split to beat, besides the save beforehand. That was really, really good. Let's see this. .225 flat. That is a little bit better than I was expecting to get today. I was thinking, you know, it's probably not going to get sub 230. And then after that terrible rock tunnel, I was like, yeah, definitely not sub 230. But, yeah, we pulled it back. First run was way worse than I remembered. That was a solid Elite Four overall. Definitely not quite ready to pull out all the risky strats, but we'll see. Definitely a lot I need to still work on with muscle memory, cursor placement, certain things that'll just hopefully become second nature with certain fights. Good stuff, though. Well, I still have about an hour and a half or so. Could do some Kalo practice with the final six. I think I do want to do that. But first, I shall be right back. That Elite Four is wild. I don't quite have enough time to do a second run. It took a lot longer to get them in IP than I wanted it to the first time. So I think I'm actually going to switch over to Kalo real quick and do some final six fights practice. Kind of curious what my overall in-game time was. I'm going to track this just because it's a nice kind of benchmarker for how my execution is. Okay, 12:30. Fun run, though.